A PDF of additional resources and worksheets accompanies this program. Simon & Schuster Audio presents Everyone Deserves a Great Manager: The 6 Critical Practices for Leading a Team by Scott Miller, Todd Davis, and Victoria Roos Olsson. Read by the authors. With a foreword by Rob Cahill, co-founder and CEO of Jhana and vice president at FranklinCovey.
This is Scott Miller. It's my privilege to introduce Rob Cahill, who honored us by writing our foreword.
Want a guaranteed conversation starter? Ask someone if they've ever had a bad manager. And then brace yourself, because almost all of us know what it's like to work for a soul-crushing, morale-killing, please-don't-make-me-go-to-work kind of manager. But if we're fortunate, we've also worked with a great manager. One who cared about us, believed in us, and helped us do our best work. Legendary Harvard Business School professor Clayton Christensen believes management is one of the most meaningful roles in the world. In his book, How Will You Measure Your Life?, he writes, "If you want to help other people, be a manager. If done well, management is among the most noble of professions. You are in a position where you have 8 or 10 hours every day from every person who works for you. You have the opportunity to frame each person's work so that at the end of every day, your employees will go home living a life filled with motivators. And the data proves it. According to Gallup, managers account for at least 70% of variance in employee engagement scores across business units. Being a great manager is one of the most influential roles and one of the hardest. When I led a team for the first time, I struggled to learn on the job. What I wouldn't have given for a Wikipedia for managers, or even better, a WebMD for my leadership aches and pains. It didn't exist. So my co-founder and I set out to create one in a drafty San Francisco basement 8 years ago. The resulting company, Jhana, was founded on the idea that everyone deserves a great manager. Jhana now serves as an online learning resource that provides bite-sized training for leaders, and our research confirmed how universally hard it was to transition into leadership, how often new managers weren't set up for success, and how little direction they received from their bosses. Our team of PhDs, researchers, writers, and technologists dove into the academic research and built a panel of managers to validate or refute their findings in the real world. What emerged was some of the best, most practical solutions for the challenges all managers face: delegating, leading people, setting the right goals, supporting people, hiring, firing, and motivating. Apparently, I wasn't the only new manager who could use the help, because Jhana took off. Managers used our practical solutions in tech companies, professional services, financial services, hospitals, manufacturing, schools, universities, and governments. To increase our impact, we joined up with FranklinCovey, one of the most respected leadership development companies in the world. Beginning with its co-founder, Dr. Stephen R. Covey, author of the book The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, FranklinCovey has nearly 4 decades of experience around these fundamental leadership issues. First, how could we help people make one of the most difficult transitions of their careers, from individual contributor to manager, giving them the confidence to overcome their self-doubt? Second, how could we help managers fulfill their potential and continue to learn and develop over time? Third, how could we help them manage the often crushing stress that comes with the job? With FranklinCovey's principle-based leadership legacy and Jhana's innovative Silicon Valley approach, we built a leadership solution that combined the best to both worlds: the 6 critical practices for leading a team, used by hundreds of thousands of managers in countries all over the world. Although created primarily for managers leading teams of individual contributors, the practices in this book apply to leaders at any level. If you're a new manager, you'll uncover the proven best practices to lead and develop your people into a high-performing team. If you're an experienced manager, focus on the practices that fill the gaps in your management training and check out the tools for your most critical interactions, such as conducting one-on-ones, setting goals, and leading through change. If you're a leader of leaders, you'll find practical ways to sharpen your managerial skills. This book can also serve as a guide to mentor new managers who report to you. If you're a human resource, learning and development, or organizational development professional, use this book to coach experienced managers and develop new and emerging leaders. If you're a C-level executive, use this book to model the practices so they manifest on the front line. If you're not using these practices, your managers probably won't either. Along with Scott, Todd, and Victoria, I have found leadership to be especially challenging, but also very rewarding. But if you're not there yet, the practices in this book will help you get there. Enjoy this journey that will inspire managers at any level to make an impact with their teams and leave a lasting legacy.
Introduction. I hate powdered sugar. It all started when I was 27 years old and 3 months into my new career with the Covey Leadership Center, what would become FranklinCovey, as a frontline salesperson for K-12 schools. After an entire life in Florida, including 4 years with the Walt Disney Company, I was excited about my new start in Utah, with its wide-open career opportunities and delightful absence of parking lot alligators. Imagine my surprise when the vice president asked if I would take on the additional role of managing a team of client service coordinators. All of the people on the team had been with the company longer than me. Surveying my new team, I rendered my judgment. They were quite capable, but in need of motivation, accountability, and a young but promising leader who could raise the bar on performance. I buckled down and got to the job at hand. The vice president was going to be thrilled with the outcomes I was able to produce. My team would revere my inspiring style and expertise. I was going to be so effective that it would only be a matter of time before I landed another promotion, a raise, and an even larger team to lead toward greatness. That's not quite what happened. Trying to increase productivity and our results, I suddenly found myself monitoring arrival and departure times. I banned personal appointments during work hours. I even asked a coordinator to respond to voicemails and report any issues to me while she was out of the office. On her honeymoon. She thought I was joking. I was not. To her credit, she flat out refused. We're good friends to this day, 22 years later. So yes, I was quite effective at destroying morale, people's self-esteem, and any shred of pride they had in their work. I was tyrannical. I was a nightmare. Fine, I was a total jackass. But I genuinely thought my brand of swagger would bring everyone in line and inspire them to new levels of engagement. Which brings us to the powdered sugar. One morning during my reign of terror, I was reading the paper at a local diner before work, while, you guessed it, eating a waffle with powdered sugar on top, when my phone rang. It was the vice president. Time for my next promotion. Instead, he began with, "You know, I've been thinking," and ended 3 minutes later with me gently, but definitely relieved from my new leadership position and moved back into the role of a frontline salesperson. I had been, in fact, unpromoted. After 3 weeks, I set my fork down, feeling sick to my stomach, and that was the end of my first leadership role and my love of powdered sugar. Fortunately, my employer, FranklinCovey, one of the world's largest leadership development organizations, offered me a second chance, many second chances. Through coaching and painful self-reflection, I learned to lead in a way that accomplished business results while developing my team. After 4 years as a successful individual producer, I was re-extended the opportunity to lead, this time for a group of 15 experienced salespeople in our higher education division. By this time, I knew how to hold accountability meetings, review pipelines, forecasts, understand what was a real sales opportunity and what wasn't. I was good at managing sales, which is very different from managing people. That crucial transition didn't happen until I was promoted to general manager of our Midwestern region. It required a whole different level of skill, a more sophisticated strategy, more compassion, and tough calls. I had to interview and hire dozens of people, and also fire a few when their contributions fell short. I had to learn to develop high performers, motivate low performers, and have difficult conversations. I had to make decisions with six-figure consequences weekly. It was through this role that I learned to become the manager my team deserved, to guide 40 people with lofty career dreams, 401ks, mortgages, and families who depended on them. I had to bring a completely new level of maturity, wisdom, and judgment. I also had to earn my leadership position. It didn't automatically come with a title. I had to behave my way to credibility. Around this time, my mentor told me, "Scott, 10 years from now, no one will remember if you met your second quarter."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.